Hey everyone, my name is Max and I'm back once again with another really cool project. This time around I found an Adirondack chair on Etsy, so I'm going to cut a couple of these out from plywood for my patio. And along the way I'm going to explain the easy process of setting this up in VCarve Pro. I'll explain how you can quickly optimize your parts to get the most out of a sheet of material, and we'll take a look at the advantage of having a vacuum table like we have on the SmartShop 2 when you're doing nested jobs like this. So here's the chair that I found on Etsy. It's actually my first time buying a file through Etsy. I wasn't sure how it was going to work, but it's actually very easy. After checkout, I got an email to a download page where I could download this file over and over and over again if in case I ever do lose the original file. Now that I have it downloaded, I'm going to open up VCarve and I'm going to create my job. The first thing it's going to ask are some basic questions about the size of the material. In this case, I have a 4-foot by 8-foot sheet of plywood. It's 3/4 inch thick. And for this project, I'm not really doing any fine engraving. These are all large cut throughs. So just the nominal dimension of 3/4 inch is fine. Next, I'm going to import the DXF file that I downloaded. And as you can see, all the parts are here. In fact, it looks like they actually provided 3 different styles of backs to choose from. So that's cool. But unfortunately, it's not laid out for a 4x8 sheet. And it goes without saying, but to lay out this many parts manually would take a lot of time, and probably I still wouldn't be able to get all these parts done on a single sheet of material. So instead, I'm going to use this nesting tool. When I open the nesting tool, the first thing it's going to do is ask for a little bit of information related to tool diameter and the spacing of the parts so that it leaves just enough room between parts and a little bit of room around the edge of the sheet. And now that I've put in that information, all I have to do is select the parts, click apply, and there we have our 4x8 sheet. There is no way that I would have ever been able to do this manually. Now that my sheet's set up, I just have to describe for the machine what I want to do with this drawing, because right now it's just a drawing. So in this case, I want to cut around the edge of each shape. That's going to be called a profile toolpath, and it's going to need a little bit of info from me one last time. In this case, we need to tell the software how deep we want to cut. So in this case, all the way through the material, plus just a little bit deeper. And I'm going to put it 100th through the material just to make sure that I get a nice clean cut. And also, I need to tell it what tool I want to use. So in this case, I'm going to use my 3/4 inch compression bit. You'll also notice as I go out here to cut it that I've set up the tool path to do a couple passes. The last pass that it does is cutting off just a sliver of material, and that strategy is called onion skinning. The advantage here is that when I go out to the machine and run this, when it cuts the last pass, there's not going to be a lot of pressure being applied, and that means it's easier for the vacuum to hold the part in place. Now that I have this all set up, I'm going to calculate. We'll get a nice preview, make sure that everything looks good. It does. So now we're going to take the file out to the machine and run it, see how it goes.